Hey everybody, it's Rich at RMAutodiag, and today we're going to have a look at a very unhappy Range Rover.
Right, okay, just to start, I'd like to thank any of my new subscribers, and if you're not a subscriber, have a look down below, click the bell for notifications. Okay, so first we've got a 2010 Range Rover Sport, and it's got the TDV8 engine in it, and we're out having a look. This car's been lying around for a bit, but it's got some suspected engine issues, so we're gonna try and prove that today. We've got the Pico out, and we're gonna do some relative compression to see if we do have a cylinder down or two or however many. So what we're gonna do is we're gonna get set up and I'll show you where we're to. Okay, so we got Pico and we've got the down here, we've got the 600 amp clamp, and we're connected to the starter motor wire for the relative compression. And what we're going to do is we've got all the injectors disconnected bar one, and I've got another amps clamp, the lower amps clamp, to do a synchronization on that so we can see one of the injectors firing, so we can see what's going on and what our firing order is. So that'll make a bit more sense when we got it on the screen. So we've got a screen set up down here, and what I'll do is we'll get a screen share on, and what I'll do is we'll crank the car over and we'll see what it does. Okay, so we've got the 600 amp current clamp set up on channel A. We've got it on the highest scale, and channel B we've got the 60 amp clamp on a 20 amp setting, and we've got, again, put that on the highest scale. And what we're going to do is I'll just wait for it to finish the end of the screen, start again, and we'll crank the car over and we'll see what it does. Okay, we stopped it there. What we'll do is we'll go to the zoom feature at the top here. You can see our injector firing on the red trace. And so if we zoom in on a section here, we should see what's going on. Okay, so instantly we can see some not too great things happening here. So that's our number 7 injector here. So we can see one peak, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, and then we're back to the start again, and we can see some considerable issues down here. So if we get the firing order up, this is synced on number 7, so we get the firing order up and we can go through that. Right, okay, for the next test we have got channel C hooked up. We've got it on just a normal probe on plus or minus 5 volts, and on the scope we've got set up for pressure pulse sensor, and what we're going to do is we're going to go into the dipstick hole with this one, and we're going to see if the compression loss is through the crankcase or, you know, past the piston. So we'll get a cranking waveform and we'll see what that looks like as well. So we'll get set up down here, focus on the screen, and say we'll do a screen share on this one as well, and I'll give it a crank. Yep, so we'll get zoomed in here and we'll see what it looks like. Okay. So we can see on some of our lower ones here, on these lower events, we've got pulses back through the crankcase on both of these. So on these lower peaks here, we can see that the compression is not taking place, it's blowing it back into the crankcase chamber, and that's what's causing the issue. So obviously this engine's going to need to be stripped down, have a look why it's doing that, and go from there. As I say, this could be done, this same test could be done in the intake if you think you've got intake valve issues and the exhaust. So it's quite an interesting thing to look at anyway. But I think this this Range Rover is fairly unhappy, but at least we've got some good, quick, non-intrusive tests here. We can quite happily say that we've got a couple of pistons that have got issues, and it looks like it's blowing it into the crankcase. So not great for the customer, but it's some interesting diagnostics for everyone. So I think everyone should have had an interesting time watching this. Thanks for watching the video, and I'll see you on the next one. Cheers.